Welcome to my quick walkthrough of building a custom SAN for home or work purposes. It actually ends up putting out quite a bit of I/O for the minimal amount of money involved in this project. I went with a Supermicro motherboard and a disk array subsystem by Supermicro. I'll be listing all the components in the description and in the video annotations so you can kind of collect that information. Everything turned out really nicely compatibility wise. I ended up using it for a VM iSCSI build out for my VMware home server. And here's the actual case. I went with the Leon Lee. I got one of the disk enclosures in there. I ended up getting two of them for a total of 10 hot swappable hard drive bays there. And I was real careful to keep the wires nice and tidy to maximize that airflow there. You can see one of them bundled there. Came with the motherboard, came with one network port and onboard VGA video card, minimize the amount of hardware you have to get and keep the case open as possible. Cleaned up the back side of that and eliminated some of the wiring from the internal side of the case. Ended up going with that Supermicro enclosure. It seemed to be real solid. I was very happy with the way yeah, quality of the construction, and very affordable comparatively with the other SATA hot swap type enclosures. There's the workhorse of the system, the SATA 2 RAID 6 capable JBOD actual RAID controller there. Great card, just very fast performer. Of course, it's a little bit on the pricey side with having 16 ports on it, but I find it to be true that you typically get what you pay for. Got the CPU, basic 2.2 Intel, and I got about 4 gig of RAM on this box. It probably won't hurt if you can afford a little extra RAM for caching purposes, bump the performance up there. So ended up labeling all my cables for troubleshooting purposes. It just makes things a little easier when you got everything bundled and tie strapped like that. Here's the close-up of the card. You can see the onboard cache there and a fan for the CPU, the onboard CPU. It actually has a HTTP web GUI configuration for kind of out-of-band management, and that's really slick. That works great. You control all the miscellaneous features of the card itself too, so that's fun to play around with if you don't want to go through the BIOS. So you don't need any additional software, so that actually worked out great in our situation. Here I have the second RAID enclosure installed and popped out the CD-ROM drive. It actually has some onboard USB slots for booting a flash drive or running an install off that. I ended up installing an OpenFiler solid free version of a SAN software implementation there. And of course I got all the wires managed for improved airflow. Got a fan on the back of each enclosure assembly and a fan, you can't really see it here, and on the front of those two hard drives. I went with two 250 gig hard drives there for the operating system. Those are RAID 1 off the motherboard RAID controller, because I didn't want to get into a situation where I was putting the OS in the actual RAID bay enclosures and you ended up pulling one of those by accident. That wouldn't go over too well. And here I have the drives removed, so you can kind of see the slide rails and the the bays. They got each terabyte drive in there. I have it configured with RAID 5. Alright, here we're going to click the drives back in. The drives seem to be nice and appropriately sized. They click back in nice and clean. They aren't real sloppy or flimsy plastic. They're nice solid. They have a LED light that comes out to the front of the actual bay, so you can see drive activity lights. So you get some kind of indication of the activity on the system or any kind of. They also have a warning light next to the activity light indicator, which is nice. A lot of the enclosures didn't have that. Okay, I got the OpenFiler installed and we're booting here through the BIOS. There's the RAID controller configuration. I'll be skipping that. I already have that pre-configured. And here's your OpenFiler boot screen using RPath Linux. We're running with version 2.3 for the time being. Alright, now we got it booted up here. And you can kind of see some activity here. I'm hitting it with I have iSCSI partition configured, hitting it with iometer. Got a about 16,000 IOPS for 4K blocks, and got about 105 megabytes using a 32K size block with a 16 Q depth on the disk, and it's humming right along. Very impressive for the larger green type drives that aren't really performance oriented. Alright, and that concludes our video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. I had a ton of fun putting this system together, and it turned out to be much nicer than I ever thought it would be. So hopefully I've inspired you to come up with something of your own or similar.